Good morning, students. In the previous lecture of the thermodynamics, we discussed about the problem 6.7 and fusion enthalpy, after that vaporization enthalpy and sublimation enthalpy. All of them are endothermic reaction, that's why delta H will be positive for all of them. Okay. After that, our next problem is problem number 6.8. Okay, so let's calculate problem number 6.8. Okay, assuming the water vapor to be perfect gas, okay, it is an ideal gas. Calculate internal energy change, that's why delta U we have to calculate. Okay, on which basis? When 1 mole of water at 100 degree Celsius and 1 bar pressure is converted to ice at 0 degree Celsius. 1 mole of water at 100 degree Celsius. Given the enthalpy of the fusion of ice, delta fuse H naught of ice is 6 kilojoule per mole. 6 kilojoule mole inverse. Okay. After that, heat capacity of water is 4.2 joule per gram per Celsius. Okay, so C has been given, it is 4.2 joule per gram per Celsius. Okay, one mole of water at 100 degree Celsius and 1 bar pressure is converted to ice at 0 degree Celsius. The change take place as follows. Okay, so this particular sum will be calculated as a two part. This particular sum will be calculated for two part. Okay, part number one. Okay, now our T1 is equal to 100 degree Celsius and our T2 is equal to 0 degree Celsius. Okay, now for this sum, our step number one. Step number one, heat released or absorbed from 100 degree Celsius to 0 degree Celsius. That's why QP, why pressure is constant. That's why 4C into delta T. Okay, now this C and the given C both are different. Given C is the special or specific heat capacity. It is specific heat capacity. Why? There are gram given over here. So we have to multiply it by the weight of the water. Now we have 1 mole of water. A mole of water has been given. It is 1 mole of water. Okay, that's why 18 gram of water are there. Therefore, our formula will be Qp equal to given weight into specific heat capacity, which is in capital letters, okay, into delta T. Now let's calculate this. Therefore Qp equal to weight of water, it is 18 gram for 1 mole because 1 mole water is been taken. Now special heat capacity is 4.2, okay, and temperature difference, so T2 minus T1, okay. Therefore Qp is equal to 18 into 4.2 into 0 minus 100. Why we have not converted Celsius into Kelvin? Because heat capacity, specific heat capacity has Celsius in the unit. That's why we have taken Celsius itself. Okay. Therefore, Qp will be equal to 18 into 4.2 into minus 100. Okay, because initial temperature was 100 degree Celsius and final temperature is 0 degree Celsius. Now 100 into 4.2 into 18. So we got answer. Qp, which is equal to delta H1 for this step, okay. So step 1 is equal to delta H1 will be equal to 7, okay, negative will be there, so negative 7560 joule value. Okay, look at this, it is over there and they have converted into kilojoule. Okay, so we have to convert it into kilojoule. Therefore delta H1 will be equal to minus 7 point, okay, joule mole inverse, not only joule, remember that, okay, 0.56 kilojoule mole inverse. Okay, this was our step number 1. After that our step number 2. Okay, what was the step number 2? 0 degree Celsius water H2 in a liquid state is converted into 0 degree Celsius ice H2O. Solid. That means freezing. Therefore, minus delta fuse H0 will be equal to 6.00 kilojoule mol inverse. Okay, therefore this negative sign will be given over here. Therefore delta fuse, or you can now delta fuse will not be there, therefore delta H2 will be equal to minus 6.00 kilojoule per mole inverse. Now addition of both the step energy, that's why our step number three. First of all, this sum is most important for you guys, so remember it. Step number 3 will be delta H is equal to delta H1 plus delta H2. Okay, add both of the result. Therefore delta H is equal to delta H1 is minus 7.56, so minus 7.56 plus minus minus 6.00, so answer will be delta H is equal to minus 13.56 kilojoule mole inverse. Okay, look at the answer. Step number 1, convert 1 mole of water 100 degree Celsius to 0 degree Celsius. So that will be our delta H1. And after that, step number 2, convert water 0 degree Celsius to ice 0 degree Celsius. That will be delta H2. Okay. Therefore, both of the addition will be minus 13.56. Okay. Now we still have to calculate delta U. Okay. For that, therefore, delta H is equal to delta U minus delta, plus delta NG RT. Now what was the reaction? Liquid to solid, so no gaseous compounds are there, that's why delta NG will be equal to 0. So delta H is equal to delta U plus 0 into RT, that's why delta H is equal to delta U will be equal to minus 13.56 kilojoule mole inverse. Okay, look at this. Therefore negligible change in the volume during the change from liquid to solid, that's why delta NG will be equal to 0. So delta H equal to delta U will be equal to minus 13.56 kilojoule per mole. Okay, so that was the most important sum from your chapter number 6. Remember, problem 6.8 is most important for you. Okay, after that our next topic is standard enthalpy of formation. Okay, in the previous lecture we discover delta RH0, which is standard reaction enthalpy. After that delta fuse H0, which is fusion, standard fusion enthalpy. After that delta vap H0, which is standard vaporization enthalpy, liquid to gas. And after that standard sub H naught, which was the sublimation enthalpy, standard sublimation enthalpy. In this lecture, we are going to start with a standard formation enthalpy. So delta F H naught, standard formation enthalpy. Formation means preparation. We have to prepare. Okay, look at this. The standard enthalpy change for the formation of one mole of compound from its element in their most stable state of aggregation is called standard molar enthalpy of formation. Its symbol is delta F H naught. Okay, this is the most important enthalpy from whole chapter. Standard formation enthalpy is most important. So remember the conditions. First condition, subscript F indicates that one mole of compound in question has been formed in its standard state from its element in their most stable state of aggregation. That means first condition, we have to prepare one mole of product only. We have to prepare only one mole of product. So for the delta HF, our first condition, one mole product, only one mole product. Okay, from where? From elements only. It will be prepared from elements only. Okay, product must be in standard state. Product must be in a standard state. These three conditions must be followed for the formation enthalpy. Only one mole product should be there. Product should be formed by elements, and product must be in the standard state. Okay, look at this. The reference state of the element is the most stable state at the aggregation at 25 degrees Celsius and 1 bar pressure. Standard temperature and standard pressure. For example, the reference state of the dihydrogen is H2 is gas, dioxygen gas, carbon graphite. Carbon is in a solid form, graphite, right? Sulfur is rhombic sulfur, respectively. The aggregation stable state. Okay, some reaction with standard molar enthalpies of formation are as follows. Some of the reaction has been given. Okay, in the first reaction they have prepared one mole of H2O. Let's prepare one mole of H2O from elements. Okay, so product will be H2O. Okay, standard form of H2O is liquid and one mole will be there. So direct arrow, this is our product. Okay, how much oxygen is there? One oxygen, that's why O2 in the standard form, and O2 is gas, but we need only one oxygen, that's why 1/2 O2. Okay, and how much hydrogen is there? Two hydrogen is there, that's why H2 in the standard form with gaseous state. So this reaction is the formation reaction of water. This reaction is formation reaction of water. For that, formation enthalpy is -285.8 kilojoule. For that reaction, delta F H naught is equal to -285.8 kilojoule mole inverse, the formation enthalpy of water. Okay, look at this, all the rules should be followed. 1 mole of product, okay, 1 mole of product is there. From elements, H2 and O2 are elements. From elements, product must be in the standard state. At 25 degrees Celsius, H2O is water. Okay, so third condition is also followed. Okay, after that, another reaction is there. Preparation of methane, CH4. So now, we are going to prepare CH4. So, CH4 at 25 degrees Celsius, it is in a gaseous form. 1 mole of product, so direct arrow. Okay? Now, H4, that's why H2 is the standard form of hydrogen element in a gaseous state, and 2H2 will be required. Why? Because 4 hydrogen are in the product. Okay? Now, reagent. Carbon in its standard state. So, carbon in the standard state is graphite. So, I will write graphite over here. Okay. I am going to sort it. So, this is a formation reaction of methane. So, the formation enthalpy of this is equal to -74.81 kilojoule per mole. So I am just going to copy it. Okay. Now our third reaction that they have asked. Look at this. Carbon graphite solid, 3 hydrogen and 1/2 oxygen for C2H5OH. Let's prepare this. We are going to prepare C2H5OH. Okay. So, C2H5OH. At 25 degrees Celsius, it is in a liquid form. 1 mole of product only. Now 2 carbons are there and 6 hydrogen are there and 1 oxygen. So O2 in a gaseous state. Okay, how much 1 oxygen is there? That's why 1/2 O2 plus 5 plus 1, 6 hydrogen is there. So H2, how much H2? 3H2 total. Okay, in a gaseous state. And 2 carbon are there. That's why 2 carbon graphite will be there. Carbon in a graphite form. Okay. Wall must be written. How much? 2. So, this will be the wall reaction of preparation of ethanol, C2H5OH, right? So, the formation enthalpy for this is delta FH naught is equal to -277.7 kilojoule per mole. Okay, so 3 reaction which they have given us. All the 3 condition must be followed for the formation enthalpy. Okay. Now, it is important to understand that a standard molar enthalpy of the formation is just a special case of reaction enthalpy. It is a special case of reaction enthalpy. Okay. Not only reaction enthalpy. Now, listen carefully. Not all reaction enthalpies are formation enthalpy. But all formation enthalpies are reaction enthalpy. All formation enthalpies are reaction enthalpy, but all reaction enthalpy is not formation enthalpy. Why? Because all the reaction enthalpy do not include elements as a reagent and only 1 mole of product. So it will be wrong. Look at this. where one mole of compound is formed by its constituent element as above the given reactions, where each one mole of each water and methane and ethanol is formed. Okay, for the explanation, look at this reaction. Calcium oxide reacts with carbon dioxide and form calcium carbonate. This reaction enthalpy is -178.3 kilojoule per mole. But look at this conditions: one mole of product CaCO3 one mole. Okay, first condition has been satisfied completely. Okay, after that, it should be prepared from the elements. CaO is compound; it is not element. So second condition is not fulfilled for the formation enthalpy. That's why this reaction is not a formation reaction, and this enthalpy cannot be formation enthalpy. That's why all formation enthalpies are reaction enthalpy, but all reaction enthalpy cannot be formation enthalpy. Okay. Likewise, they have given us one another reaction. Look at this. In this reaction, both the reagent are in a elemental state, but they have prepared 2 mole of product. We need only 1 mole of product. So this is also not a formation enthalpy. But what if I want to discover formation enthalpy of this one? I will simply divide reaction enthalpy by 2. Look at this. For this reaction, if I divide reaction enthalpy by 2, I will get a formation enthalpy. So divide this reaction by 2. You will get formation enthalpy. Okay. Standard enthalpy of the formation of some common substance has been given in a table 6.2 here. But this table is not useful because in every single sum they will provide the information. Okay. By convention, standard enthalpy of the formation of an element in reference state, it is most stable state of aggression, that's why it is zero. Okay. What does this statement mean? Simple. All elements have formation enthalpy zero. All elements have formation enthalpy zero. So, formation enthalpy of H2 will be zero. Formation enthalpy of O2 will be zero. Formation enthalpy of carbon graphite will be 0. Formation enthalpy of H2 will be 0. Graphite 0. H2 0. O2 0. Is that clear? All the elements have 0 formation enthalpy. Okay? Suppose you are a chemical engineer and want to know how much heat is required to decompose calcium carbonate to lime and carbon dioxide with all the substance here. Okay, this is the reaction they have given to you. Okay, we have to decompose calcium carbonate into calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. So we will simply use our original equation. What was the original equation? Reaction enthalpy. Addition of all the enthalpies of product minus addition of all the enthalpy of reagent. Okay, but at that time we used molar enthalpy. Remember, look at this. We used molar enthalpy, del HM only, right? Now this molar enthalpy will be changed to formation enthalpy. So instead of HM, I am going to write H delta F H naught. Okay. Look at this. Now, the reaction CaCO3, which is solid, on the reaction decomposition, it will give me CaO, calcium oxide solid, and carbon dioxide as a gaseous form. Now, our standard reaction enthalpy for this will be equal to addition of formation enthalpy. So, delta F H naught for CaO, okay, plus delta FH naught for CO2 minus reagents. That's why delta FH naught CaCO3. So that will be your answer. Look at this. They have written all the values. Okay. So 1 mole of CaO is there. So 1 mole of enthalpy. After 1 mole of carbon dioxide is there. So 1 into carbon dioxide enthalpy. These are the products minus reagent. You will get your answer. Thus, enthalpy reaction enthalpy comes positive. Here reaction enthalpy is positive. That's why decomposition of calcium carbonate is an endothermic process, and you will heat it to get a desired product. Okay, that was all for this lecture. In the next lecture, we are going to discuss about thermochemical equations, and after that, Hasse's law. Okay.